بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد يوشك الأمم أن تداعى عليكم كما تداعى The nations will get together, people of party will get together to consume the Muslim Ummah, to fragment them, to devour them. Although they will be completely annihilated, devastated, ravaged, no trace of the Muslim Ummah. Maulana Yusuf Ali, before he passed away, gave a few sermons. One of them was about making an Ummah, and he said that the first step is to follow the Ittabi'u Millata Ibrahim Hanifa. Allah has told us to follow the way of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, where firstly the tashkil was made for him to give sacrifice. فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ All the sacrifice that was called for, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam passed the sacrifices, passed the test, fulfilled the requirements. أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ He said, Ya Allah, I am ready on your taqaza. Ya, I am ready on your command. The first tashkil, he got ready. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made his wife. Since a tarbiyat was made, the tashkil, the test was put forward. Did Allah command you for this? Yes, it is Allah's command. Allah will not wipe us out. She was ready in the valley of death to sacrifice her life and her son's life for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the same answer which Ibrahim and Hajar radiallahu anhuma gave, the son gave, that I see and I am slaughtering you. He said, Oh my father, Ya Abati, if Alma tu'mar, if Allah has commanded you, then fulfill the command of Allah. Meaning the command of Allah is more important for a believer at any given time, more important than his wealth, even more important than his very life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wala yanzi anna Allah min suduri aduwikum al-mahaba. Allah will snatch this rob and this awe from the hearts of the people that are plotting against you. Mahaba comes through this sifat. Maulana Yusuf explained, now the whole household is made. If you want to change the world, first start with yourself, your wife, your children. The lockdown was an ideal opportunity for us to create this mahal, this millat Ibrahim in our houses, or we're just busy on Netflix and on YouTube and watching all the propaganda, batil news stations and passing our time. Or did we utilize it to capitalize on our akhirat? If a person calculates all the movies of Hollywood and Bollywood and Netflix and YouTube, and all the layani that a person watches his whole life, calculate the amount of hours of our life has been dedicated for this, and how much has it benefited me, my wife, my children? And if I had utilized it in the commands of Allah, in tilawat, in dua, in amal, in dhikr, how much benefit and faida would it have been for me and my family and for the whole of mankind? A believer is wise. We see Hazrat Umar radiallahu anh, a soldier comes to Medina Munawwara, sees him lying under a tree. Is this Amirul Mu'mineen? The person that the world's fear, great leaders, hearts tremor with fear, no bodyguards, no security, no backup. Such a simpleton, such a ordinary, normal person. So Rab comes through taqwa, comes through connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ummah needs to be building that connection. And we have to understand that the Muslim ummah has been sent for the hidayat of mankind. We've been sent for the hidayat of the people of America, for the hidayat of the people of China, for the hidayat of the people of the entire world till the day of Qiyamah. The elements that are behind the scenes are the people that you have to be concerned about. As for the people, the everyday people don't even have a clue that they are a pawn in this big game. Their taxes and their monies and everything of the resources of the country are used to empower a few elite groups that are masterminding this entire operation and planning. So as a Muslim Ummah, we have been sent with a responsibility for the guidance of mankind. But if I cannot even guide my own self, if I cannot even come close to my own guidance, my own family's guidance. Where will I ever be used by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hidayat of mankind? We see that part of this plotting was and to control any system. One is economically, you need to control it. We look at the biggest revenues in the world. Number one is arms, which no data is out there. But just a simple aircraft carrier costs around $13 billion. The research and effort gone into the F-35 combat aircraft costs around $1.4 trillion. So in the arms race, number one, they've got it under control. Anybody comes into that direction, they'll wipe them out immediately. Pharmaceuticals, tech and telecom, entertainment and business sector. We explained it in the banking sector, in the economic sector. Senior bankers had strangely just committed suicide. So if you come in the way of their planning, then they plan an assassination or a suicide. Likewise in the pharmaceutical industry, and that is a very, very big game. Likewise also, there's been mysterious deaths of people who are in the field of holistic treatment, natural treatment, whether it's chiropractors, homeopaths, etc. These people are dying at an alarming rate. And I'll just give you one or two examples. June 2015, Dr. Jeffrey Bradstreet, he had reportedly shot himself in the chest after his offices were raided by the FDA agents. 3 days before he had died, the agents issued a warrant. Why? Because in his clinic, he had found great hope in treating illnesses like cancer, autism, chronic fatigue, and possibly Parkinson's. And the research papers that have been published have found great success with regards to his treatment of cancer. Imagine finding a cure to cancer. How much revenue do you wipe out of the global pharmaceutical industry? In another article, Freedom Outpost, back in July, 5 holistic doctors had met up with suspicious deaths within 30 days. Some of them were missing, some were found dead under suspicious circumstances, 7 inside a month. In a span of 90 days, 11 doctors have been found dead under suspicious circumstances. Some were found dead to apparent suicide. The following is just an extract from an article of somebody had written, Julie Wilson. A wave of mysterious deaths continues to plague practitioners in the field of holistic medicine, including chiropractors, herbalists, and other alternate healers. With the latest fatality involving a licensed chiropractor who also worked as a full-time teacher. And then she goes into detail to explain what had happened. So like that in the pharmaceutical industry, every industry, wherever there's a need to control and regulate it, up to a president, JFK, November 1963, Lee Harvey Oswald assassination. He was a former US Marine. When he was caught, he said clearly, I'm just a fall man. His bullets, apparently, Allah knows best what's the truth. We do not guarantee anything. Allah knows best. But he said that he was just a fall man. And because you have to kill evidence, 2 days later, he was shot dead. That's the president of the United States of America. When it comes to the monetary system also, Gaddafi, very famous, he wanted to create the gold dinar. He had collected gold reserves, approximately 143 tons. There are more other narrations, the exact figures are not clear, because when the invasion took place, obviously a lot of it was stolen and looted. And they had amongst the top 25 world reserves of gold. And he sponsored Sarkozy's presidential election, different amounts, 10, 15, 20, 50 million euro, thinking that if I secure the president, but he didn't realize that behind the president is other people that control the president. And that's how they've been doing it. They put their own people in senior positions. That's how you control a country. Same thing, Saddam Hussein, he wanted his oil to be paid in euros. Invasion took place. King Faisal also his own family, his half-brother's son, his nephew, who just returned from the US, Faisal bin Musaid, in front of him in broad daylight, took out a gun and shot him. Just in front of him, directly, the king was assassinated. Why? Because, and they say he was behind the crisis of 1973, the oil embargo, but he was pushing towards his payment of oil in gold, and he was pro-Palestinian. Ziaul-Haq, General Ziaul-Haq, we know he used to make mashura. We've heard from ulama with Mufti Zain al-Abidin. We won't get into detail of the different things that happened, but just one thing significant is his C-130 plane, which has a Lockheed, crashed. It had four engines now. One engine can fail, two engines can fail. Even if four engines fail and you can ask a pilot, there's a glide mode which they can try to escape. These are the Pakistan pilots amongst the best in the world. But after the crash, there was no test taken place. The post-mortems of the people, bodies weren't done. Also, the doctors, the bodies of the hospital, the bodies were, they were transferred and no post-mortems were taken place in detail. There was a full cover-up. All evidence was made to disappear. Then Commodore Zahir Zaid, who secretly took pieces of the plane while it was there, he did some chemical analysis and he found a lot of phosphorus. So the plane was three things. One is they put gas in the cockpit so the pilots would be disorientated. They didn't want to take a chance because he was a senior person. Pakistan was in the height of nuclear advancement. So they had to make sure he's taken out properly. Secondly, there was, because of the phosphorus traces of a bomb which was planted in the plane and a projectile as well. So from all three avenues, even the family afterwards decided to prosecute Lockheed. They got a senior lawyer from the US. When they spoke to him, he said, "I will sponsor a lot of things. This is a deal, that the case of the century." Then he just disappeared overnight. So they phoned him and he said, "You know what? The person from the Civil Aviation Authority from the US had lunch with me." And he said, "Don't contact me ever again." And that whole case disappeared. And then Akram Awan, who was a senior officer, was held in espionage, explains in detail, and we won't get into it, of how the whole plot took place. But senior people in strategic positions have been eliminated overnight. Now, if we look at China and coming to the forefront, why do they fit the criteria? And let us search Vision 2030. We'll see the whole world is moving to Vision 2030. People are very obedient. They don't revolt. They follow 100% guns. There's no proliferation of guns. It's not easy accessible. Then the monitoring system, whether it's monitoring each person's movement, monitoring, when you go to China, you'll see literally on every street there's cameras, they know exactly every last detail of every citizen. Then the cashless system, since China will initiate the cashless system, where everything will be electronic, no need for physical money. Then you need a people that don't have any religion, no deen. 90% of China are atheists, non-religious. And then obviously the aspect of diet, and other aspects which fits the criteria. So that's a communist country and that's in the forefront. If you just look at data on 2019 September, US is the biggest economy from the 86 trillion world GDP, US 20 trillion, China 13 trillion. That's 24% and 16%, means these two countries hold 40% of the world's GDP. In forecast Vision 2030, they say China from 13 is going to move to 64 trillion. They will be the biggest economy in the world. They'll be controlling. We can speculate. You don't need to get into that. So we have to be really careful, vigilant. We see that Dajjal will have, these are all forefronts, the preparation. It's too obvious. And if we are saying that Dajjal is so clear, black and white, then not necessarily he'll be clear enough, because he will be a deceiver. So we'll get into that inshallah when we come to Dajjal. But just two things to remember. In the dream that was seen, Dajjal did not have the kafir written on his forehead. He looked like a savior, like a prophet, somebody that was genuine, 100% there to save the world, a Samaritan, somebody's there to save humanity. Number two, if we just study the Kafara, in English, K-F-I-R, that is the Israeli Aircraft Industries. And their first flight was in 1973. From then, you'll see they've supported countries across the world, the United States Navy, the C-1, C-12 fighter jets. In the front, you'll see clearly, like in the forehead of a person, the front and even the tail now, recently it's clear, Kafir. In English, it's K-F-I-R. It's clearly on the plane. It's visible, it's vivid. So not necessarily it has to be on the forehead of Dajjal. Allah knows best, and we can be wrong as well. But on all the instruments of Dajjal, it could have his name, which he will be using. There may be other meanings also, which Nabi alayhi salam has alluded to, that is far beyond our understanding, as we are humans, we are full of flaws and our intellect is full of deficiencies. But the ilm of Nubuwwat is wahi and revelation, and that is perfect and that is complete. Even if we look at just one last thing, which is just maybe part of this topic of assassinations and taking down people, and it has been a matter of conspiracies for decades, and this has been going around for a while, was with regards to Princess Diana. Now if we look at again the history of France, the city of Paris was built by the Merovingians, a medieval dynasty which ruled France for numerous generations. Before, in the initial stages, their religion was a brand of paganism, means like the Egyptians, the satanic worshippers, they were part of that cult also. And the Pont d'Alma tunnel, that was a sacred site dedicated to the moon goddess Diana, where they used to practice the ritual sacrifice. During those ceremonies, it was in utmost importance that they sacrifice a victim died inside the underground temple. The assassination of Diana was like a reenactment of this pagan tradition. And if you go back into history and you see that the Merovingians were the mythology, it was a over 1,500 years ago, they were a Frankish dynasty. And they had control of modern day, which is today France, Germany, Switzerland, Austria, and the lower countries down. And in the Middle Ages, these kingdoms were the most powerful and most important political hubs, which emerged after the collapse of the Western Roman Europe. And these dynasties, their primary goddess was Diana. And they say that it was part of their ritual. Besides the ritual, there was very, very strategically, possibly, if her accepting Islam would have caused a revolution in the world and did not suit the people that are behind all of this here, and there was a great need to take her out. Whether it is like that or not, Allah knows best. Innahum yakiduna kayda, they will plot. The people of Iman will make effort on the Iman, on the A'mal. That is our only hope in this time of halak and conditions. More than we have yaqeen on the medicine and all the things that we are taking, let us read our du'as, read our A'mal and take precautions. Medically we need to take precautions, whichever avenue we need to take precautions. Let us follow the instructions that is needed. More importantly, let us follow the instructions of Allah and His Rasul. We just concluded most of the surahs to read in the evening. We done Tabarak, Waqia, Sajda, Yasin, Rahman, Dukhan, and the Musabbihat. Hazrat Irbad bin Sariya radiallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet would not sleep before reciting the Musabbihat. And it has more virtues than 1,000 verses. Surah Hadid, Hashar, Saf, Chumat, Taghabun, and A'la. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal, wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.